Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we dive into a fascinating topic, the chosen ones. If you've ever felt like your strong personality sets you apart and maybe even intimidates those around you, this video is for you. We'll explore 6 key points to understand why this happens and how to meet these unique challenges with grace and empathy. So let's get started. Many of us with strong personalities often wonder why our presence can seem oppressive to others, even when we have the best intentions. It's a common experience that can lead to misunderstandings and missed connections. But don't be afraid. By gaining a deeper understanding of these dynamics, we can transform what might seem like a barrier into an incredible strength. Whether it's at work, in social settings, or within your family, learning to balance your powerful energy with accessibility can make all the difference. Point 1. Clear vision and strong opinions. Chosen ones, you often have a clear vision of your goals and aren't afraid to express your opinions. This decisiveness and confidence make you natural leaders. You know what you want, and you're willing to speak up and take initiative. But here's the thing, while some people admire this quality, others might feel intimidated or uncomfortable. It's crucial to balance your assertiveness with empathy. Remember, being a strong personality doesn't mean being domineering or disrespectful. Strive to express your thoughts in a way that acknowledges and respects the feelings of others. For instance, when presenting your ideas, consider phrasing them in a way that invites dialogue rather than shutting it down. Use phrases like, "I believe," or "from my perspective," to open the floor for others to share their views. Additionally, active listening can play a vital role in balancing your strong opinions. By genuinely listening to others' viewpoints, you show that you value their input, which can help mitigate feelings of intimidation. This approach not only fosters a more inclusive environment, but also enriches your own understanding and decision-making process. By doing so, you can maintain your strong presence without alienating those around you. Your goal should be to inspire and lead through mutual respect and understanding, creating a dynamic where everyone feels heard and valued. This not only enhances your relationships, but also solidifies your role as a compassionate and effective leader. Point 2. Impact of a strong presence. Have you ever walked into a room and felt the energy shift? Your presence can be both inspiring and overwhelming. Your confidence and authority can sometimes overshadow others, making them hesitate to approach or engage with you. This isn't necessarily because you are doing something wrong. It's simply the natural impact of a strong, confident personality. To mitigate this, try to be more accessible in your interactions. Small adjustments, like a friendly tone and an open posture, can make a huge difference. For example, when you enter a room, make a conscious effort to smile and make eye contact with those around you. This simple gesture can instantly make you seem more approachable. Additionally, consider how you position yourself physically in a space. Standing or sitting in a more relaxed and open manner can signal to others that you are approachable and open to conversation. Try to avoid crossing your arms or appearing closed off, as these can be seen as signs of defensiveness or unapproachability. Engaging in light, casual conversation can also help break down barriers. Ask people about their interests, share a little about your own, and show genuine curiosity about their lives. This can help others feel more comfortable and valued in your presence. By making these small but significant changes, you can transform your strong presence into a source of comfort and inspiration, rather than intimidation. This approach helps you form deeper, more positive connections, ensuring that your natural confidence and authority are seen as welcoming and supportive rather than overwhelming. Point 3. Challenges faced by intense personalities. Being a chosen one comes with unique challenges. Your friends and family might criticize your intensity or fail to appreciate you as you deserve. Some people might even distance themselves simply because they don't understand your passion and drive. This can be particularly disheartening because your intensity is often a reflection of your deep commitment and desire to make a positive impact. it's important to balance your intensity with empathy. Recognize that not everyone operates with the same level of passion or energy. Use your heightened awareness to create an environment of understanding and support. When you notice that someone seems overwhelmed by your intensity, take a step back and try to understand their perspective. Ask open-ended questions and listen actively to their responses. Embrace your role with humility and grace, knowing that your strength lies not only in your assertiveness, but also in your ability to connect deeply with others. Show your loved ones that you care about their feelings and that you value their input. This can be as simple as expressing appreciation for their support or acknowledging their concerns in a thoughtful way. Moreover, practice patience and give others the time they need to understand your vision and passion. By doing so, you build bridges of trust and mutual respect. Remember that empathy and understanding can transform potential conflicts into opportunities for deeper connections. Incorporate moments of reflection into your routine, where you consider how your actions and words affect those around you. This self-awareness can help you adjust your approach and foster more positive interactions. By balancing your intense drive with a compassionate approach, you create a harmonious environment where your passion can inspire rather than intimidate. This balance allows you to harness your full potential while nurturing the relationships that matter most to you. Point 4. Balancing assertiveness and approachability. Maintaining a balance between assertiveness and approachability is key. Your directness and strong opinions are valuable, but it's essential to be aware of how they're perceived. Some people might find your level of frankness intimidating, even aggressive. This can lead to misunderstandings or make others feel uncomfortable in your presence. To avoid this, try to convey your thoughts in a friendly tone and show genuine interest in others' perspectives. For instance, when you have an opinion to share, consider how you frame it. Instead of saying, "This is the only way to do it," you could say, "Here's one way we could approach this. What do you think?" This slight shift in language can make a significant difference in how your message is received. Additionally, practice active listening. Show that you value what others have to say by nodding, making eye contact, and providing feedback that demonstrates you are truly engaged in the conversation. Phrases like, "I see your point," or "That's an interesting perspective," can help validate their views and make them feel heard. By being empathetic and compassionate, you can bridge the gap between your intense personality and the needs of those around you. This means not only understanding their feelings, but also expressing your own in a way that is considerate. For example, if someone disagrees with you, instead of immediately countering their argument, acknowledge their viewpoint and then share your thoughts. Also, be mindful of your body language. Open gestures, such as uncrossed arms and relaxed postures, can make you appear more approachable. A warm smile can go a long way in making others feel comfortable around you. This approach makes your presence more welcoming and less intimidating, fostering positive connections. By blending your assertiveness with approachability, you create an environment where open dialogue thrives and everyone feels respected. This balance not only enhances your relationships, but also allows your leadership qualities to shine in a more inclusive and supportive way. Point 5. Leadership and inclusivity. As a chosen one, you often find yourself in leadership roles. Your decisiveness and clarity of purpose naturally put you in charge. These qualities make you an effective leader, capable of guiding others and making sound decisions. However, it's crucial to involve others in decision-making processes. People want to feel included and have their voices heard, and this inclusion fosters a sense of teamwork and mutual respect. To achieve this, proactively seek out the opinions and ideas of others. For example, during meetings or group discussions, make a point to ask quieter team members for their thoughts. Encourage an environment where everyone feels comfortable sharing their ideas without fear of being dismissed or overlooked. This can be as simple as saying, "I'd love to hear what you think about this," or "What are your suggestions on this issue?" When faced with a decision, ask for input and sincerely consider the suggestions offered. This doesn't mean you have to implement every idea, but showing that you value others' perspectives is key. Acknowledging their contributions with phrases like, "That's a great idea. Let's explore that further," or "I appreciate your input. It gives us a new angle to consider," can go a long way in making others feel valued. This inclusive approach not only enriches the decision-making process, but also demonstrates humility and wisdom. It shows that you value others' contributions, which in turn strengthens the bonds of collaboration. When people feel that their opinions matter, they are more likely to be engaged, motivated, and committed to the collective goals. Furthermore, creating a sense of belonging is essential in any group dynamic. When team members feel included, they are more likely to support the leader and the group's objectives. Inclusivity fosters trust and loyalty, and it can lead to more innovative solutions as diverse perspectives are considered. Remember, effective leadership is not just about making decisions. It's about creating an environment where everyone feels empowered to contribute. By valuing and integrating others' insights, you not only enhance the quality of your decisions, but also build a strong, cohesive team. This approach underscores the importance of humility in leadership and exemplifies the wisdom of inclusive practices. It's a testament to your strength as a leader when you can balance decisiveness with the ability to listen and adapt, ensuring everyone feels a part of the journey. Point 6. Improving social interactions. Finally, let's talk about social interactions. If you notice that you're not often invited to social events, it might be because others find your energy too strong or oppressive in these moments of joy and relaxation. Your intense presence, while beneficial in many situations, can sometimes make social settings feel less casual and more formal. To change this dynamic, show enthusiasm for social events and make a conscious effort to be approachable. Start by expressing genuine interest in the activities and gatherings your friends and colleagues enjoy. When you receive an invitation, respond with excitement and gratitude, showing that you value the opportunity to connect outside of professional or serious contexts. Once you're at a social event, engage in lighthearted conversations. Share personal stories that reveal your human side, anecdotes that are funny, relatable, or show your vulnerabilities. Humor is a powerful tool in making connections, so don't be afraid to laugh at yourself and share moments of levity. Make a conscious effort to listen more than you speak. Ask open-ended questions about others' lives, interests, and experiences. Showing genuine curiosity about others' stories can make them feel valued and appreciated, fostering a sense of camaraderie. For example, instead of focusing the conversation on your latest achievements, you could ask, "What have you been passionate about lately?" Or, "Tell me about a fun experience you've had recently." Additionally, practice nonverbal cues that convey approachability. Maintain open body language, such as uncrossed arms and frequent eye contact. Smile often and use gestures that invite others into the conversation, like nodding in agreement or leaning slightly forward to show engagement. By making these small but significant changes, you help others see you as more than an intimidating figure. They start to recognize your warmth, humor, and relatability. Over time, this will increase your chances of being included in social activities as people begin to feel more comfortable around you and look forward to your company. Improving your social interactions isn't about diminishing your strong personality, but rather about adding dimensions to it. Balancing intensity with approachability allows you to form deeper, more meaningful connections in both professional and personal settings. It shows that you are versatile and can adapt your energy to fit different environments, making you not only a respected leader, but also a cherished friend and companion. Being a chosen one means having a unique purpose. Your strong presence and spiritual authority can be overwhelming, but with conscious effort, you can transform this strength into a quality that inspires respect and builds genuine connections. True leadership lies in being approachable, empathetic, and genuinely interested in others. By balancing these qualities, you can become a figure that others admire and feel comfortable with. Thank you so much for watching. If this content resonated with you, please like, comment, and subscribe to the Balance Journey channel. Share this video with anyone who might benefit, and let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Until the next video, my friends, keep shining your light and embracing your unique path.